Good morning, Gators, and welcome back to another fine day here at school.
On today's Feel Good episode, we're going to be bringing Tides of Joy to you and a bunch of stuff from our school. Stay tuned because we're here to warm your hearts. GNN starts now.
You know, Lauren, as I'm surfing the web checking the news, it looks like we only hear about bad news. Why do you think that is?
Maybe it's because of the more and more people that we see that are like the Grinch who have hearts three times too small.
I know, right? Take a look at this news story. McDonald's is changing their ingredients to make their food healthier. Oh, the horror!
That's not exactly what I meant by bad news.
At least we have some good news here at school. Miss Noel's class was recently reading about how animals go without their basic supplies, and they decided to take action.
Imagine being left alone with no one to help you. This is the case for many animals in Polk County. Luckily, there are people willing to help these animals, and now you can help too.
Operation Santa Paws is sort of an idea that Justin Judd had in 2001, where everything gets donated, like Toys R Tots, to children and families, but there's always pets in shelters or pets from families that can't take care of them anymore.
Miss Noel's class was inspired to help after reading about the organization in one of their lessons. After reading this, the students immediately took charge.
Because I feel sad about the dogs.
So we can keep pets safe.
Now you can help by bringing in various pet supplies that then will be donated to the SPCA.
They can bring in blankets, treats, food, puppy pads, bowls. The last day would be the 20th, if they can bring them in by the 20th.
This is the season of giving, and what you give will make somebody, or should I say, some animals' day. I'm Ryan, reporting for GNN.
Good job, Miss Noel's class. Here you go, enjoy your book.
As we're continuing to spread cheer throughout school, we figured we'd give Miss Baldwin a break.
And it looked like she needed it. The thing I'm gonna miss most is all the delicious treats that I get to make with people I get to participate with, like the frosted Christmas cookie.
Oh my goodness, Lauren, didn't you know baked goods are bad for your teeth? Maybe you should try a more healthier holiday option, like a string cheese snowman or a fruit Christmas tree. Maybe you should consult with your dentist.
Actually, I don't have to go far for that because I just talked to the dentist that came here to school, and here's our news reporter Brayden to fill us in.
Wow, just look at these teeth. So shiny and white with no cavities. You could tell she's been brushing. Some of you may not know the proper way to brush and take care of your teeth. Lucky for you, a dentist came to your school to show you the proper way to take care of your teeth. Recently, Miss Stacy Catalano from Dr. Yazrebi's dentist office came to speak with special students.
It's important to go to the dentist because it's important to keep your teeth in good condition to prevent cavities.
One of the common misconceptions is that people don't have to worry about taking care of their baby teeth because they're just going to lose them anyways.
But actually that's false because you have your adult teeth are already formed underneath. So if we don't take care of our baby teeth, then when our adult teeth come in, then they're going to come in bad.
According to Ms. Catalano, someone should start going to the dentist as soon as they get their first tooth, and it is recommended that you go to the dentist twice a year. When most people think of going to the dentist, they think of shots and drills, but in reality, it's filled with a smiling face just cleaning your smile.
When you go to the dentist, we actually take x-rays of your teeth, we take pictures of your teeth, we clean their teeth, we do a full dental examination, and then we put fluoride on their teeth, and then we go over with the parent any, if there's any type of dental treatment that needs to be done, and we go over proper brushing and flossing with the child.
So next time you're getting ready for bed, don't forget the most important step, brushing your teeth. I'm Dentist Brayden, reporting for GNN.
Hey Gators, today I'm going to bring you your 411. First, Miss Butler has a special surprise for the students who have perfect attendance from November 26th through December 21st. Number 2. Attention first graders, you have a field trip today going to the Explorations. We hope you have a fun time and remember, be on your best behavior. The last day till winter break is Friday, December 21st. I hope you're ready for another holiday of fun. See you back Monday, January 7th.
Remember, being kind isn't always an action. Sometimes it's just saying the right words.
Here's our top five ways of being nice and spreading good cheer. Smiling at people lets them know that you are pleasant. Look them in the eye and smile, or give them a wide grin. It doesn't matter which.
When you're walking past someone, acknowledge their presence with a simple hi or hello.
Be a good listener. Listen when other people are talking to you. It isn't nice to just ignore other people's opinions and stories.
Always use your manners. Say please and thank you.
This is the ability to put yourself in other shoes. Empathy is not something that you are born with. It is something that you need to work on.
Our art teacher, Miss Roberts, has recently entered a couple pieces of art to the Polk Museum.
Out of all those that were entered, only one was chosen to be displayed at the museum.
When you think of art, you may think of lines, shapes, and famous people who cut off their ears. But one of our students is becoming famous at an early age. Recently, kindergarten student Avriella Reading's artwork was chosen to represent Spessart L. Holland Elementary at the Polk Museum of Art.
This is my first time. I was really happy and excited to get the award.
Well, every year, the Polk Museum of Art allows us to submit students' work. And this year it was K through 5, and I could only submit 15 pieces.
Where the project was entered, Abigail Reading was learning the concept of art colors.
We learned about primary colors.
The primary colors are red, yellow, and blue.
And then the following week, we cut out shapes of secondary colors.
Purple, green, orange.
Her work was the only one from our school that was selected because of her two things: her craftsmanship and her attention to detail.
So we just look for artwork that is ready to hang and just really, really good.
Who knows? We might have a Leonardo da Vinci at our school. I'm Avery reporting for GNN.
Sadly, this episode of GNN is about over.
You see, George, there are other people out there spreading the holiday cheer and showing kindness.
Thank you. I bet that person's heart just grew 3 times too big.
Now there's only one more thing you all have to do before you can start your day.
Is that showing a random act of kindness?
Good thought, but I was going to say stand for the pledge.
From all of us at GNN, have a great day.
And even better tomorrow.